Hi, welcome to Scotch Plains Fanwood High School. I'm Anthony Albanese, along with Andrew Schwartz. We are today at a Scotch Plains Fanwood wrestling meet against the Cranford Cougars. Andy, how does this weigh in this conference?
Well, right now, Scotch Plains is ranked at 7-2, and Cranford's record is also 7-2 as well. So, there are no teams left in the Watchon Conference. You know, either the American or the National, that have an undefeated record. All of them have at least one loss. You know, Union, Linden, Westfield, and Cranford and Scotch Plains with records of 7-2. What this match is going to do, it's not going to decide a champion or anything. What it's going to do is help out in the race toward being champion. Whoever wins is going to have an advantage.
You're seeing the Cranford team warm up right now. Scotch Plains will be out in just a moment.
Let's see, the Cranford lineup right now, at 103 they have John Kukula wrestling. At 112 they have Mike Carpenter wrestling. He's a very good wrestler. At 119, Cranford has their only state champion, Willie Carpenter. At 125 they have Pete Scholes wrestling. At 130 they have Eric Nowiski wrestling, and he's going to be going against Spot Brown. 135 they have Jason Alvator. 140 Luke Lukash. 145 Nick Lettery. 152 Brian Lettery. At 160 they have Wayne Bender. 171 Brian Nordstrom. At 189 they have George Ennisser, and at heavyweight they have Rich Pinto. It's a pretty sturdy and strong lineup.
Well, I asked you during the last match, and who do you think is going to win this? Well, now it's all tied up. This is tough. Who do you think is the stronger of the teams?
I can't really say which is a stronger team just yet. We'll have to wait and see for the first couple matches. What's going to happen is...
You think the lightweights are going to dominate, or heavyweights for our side?
What's going to happen is the lightweights have to win a couple key matches at 103, 119, and 125. If we can win those matches, then there's not much of a problem, because Cranford in the middle is very strong, but on the bottom, on the lower weights, they're very strong. If we can win some in the lower weights and then some in the middle weights,
and now you're seeing the Scotch Plains Fairmont High School team come out, consisting of Pat Bartels at 103, 112 George Mendez, 119 Mark Donadio, 125 Mike Marcovecchio, 130 Andy Brown, 135 Pete San Giuliano, 140 Ralph San Giuliano, both cousins, 145 Mike Kane, 152 Scott Rosander, 160 Dave Osislo, 171 Mark Dambau, 189 Mark Gottlick, and our heavyweight is Al Scarpa.
Right now in the middle of the circle out there, you see our captains this year, senior Mark Dambau and senior Andy Brown. Okay, there has been one change in the roster. I see at 189 we have instead of Mark Gottlick wrestling, we have Kevin Burke wrestling. Kevin Burke is wrestling at 189 instead of Mark Gottlick. My mistake. So far for Scotch Plains, the record I said before is 7-2. They're a very strong team toward the bottom and in the middle. They do have a few weak spots. However, their weak spots are complemented by the overall strong wrestlers that are around them. At 103, Pat Bartels, last year a state champion, only a sophomore this year, is a very, very consistent and good wrestler. 119, they have Mark Donadio, who's a very good wrestler. The captains at 130, Andy Brown, and 171, Mark Dambau, are consistent varsity wrestlers. 145, senior Mike Kane, and at heavyweight, they have senior Al Scarpa. This will definitely be a very good match. Here comes the Cranford team. Cranford team right now is coming out on the mat in their whites. Scotch Plains team just working out. Scotch Plains coaches this year are head coach Len Zanowitz and assistant coach James Sockin.
As I think we mentioned during our last matchup, these coaches have been doing this for a hell of a long time.
Yes, Len Zanowitz has been coaching here for at least 20 years. He's been a very consistent coach and a very good coach. He really loves the sport of wrestling. He's also an assistant baseball coach as well as an assistant football coach. Now the Raiders are in the middle of the circle, getting an inspirational message from the captains, getting ready. The chant of Raiders, and they're ready. And right now, Coach Brez is about to do the introductions. There you see the Raider bench. There's the 1-3 matchup about to take place.
For Frankfurt, 1-2 wrestlers Mike Carpenter. For Chris Sullivan at 112 pounds. For Scott Twain, George Mendez.
At 112, Frankfurt weighed in two wrestlers, Mike Carpenter and Chris Sullivan.
At 119 pounds, for Frankfurt, Ken Hartman. For Scott Twain, Mark Donadio. At 125 pounds for Frankfurt, Dean Schultz. For Scott Twain, Mike Martinvecchio, or Mike Rubin.
Mike Rebeth also weighing in at 125 for Scotch Plains.
130 pounds, Frankfurt, Eric Mawicki, for Scotch Plains, Andy Brown.
There you see Spot Brown, senior captain of the wrestling team.
At 135, Frankfurt, Jason Alvator, Scotch Plains, Peter St. Joanne.
There you see Ralph San Giuliano, the second of the San Giuliano cousins on the wrestling team this year. Mike Kane, another senior member of the team, 145. Scott Rosander.
160 pounds
for Wayne
Bender. Scott Wayne, David
Osvislo. There you see David Osvislo, or Oz, as he's called by all his friends.
171 pounds for Frankfurt, Ryan
Cornstrom.
For Scott Wayne, Mark Dambau.
There you see senior co-captain Mark Dambau. That's right, 171.
For Frankfurt, George Minister. For Scott Wayne, Mark.
As you said before, number 89 has probably been changed to Mark Alec and Kevin Burke. One of the two are going to wrestle. Okay, the lineups are finished. Now, going to play the national anthem.
And now we will stand for the national anthem as it is played.
Thank you.
Of course, our prayers go out to our servicemen and women serving in the United States military operation Desert Storm in the Persian Gulf. We'll be starting up momentarily here at Scottish Plains Family High School. First up is 103 Pat Bartels for Scottish Plains, and Cranford is John Cocolo.
Right now, the captains are out on the mat with the referee. Our co-captains for Scottish Plains, Andy Brown and Mark Dambow. And the Cranford captain. If we're tossing the coin to see which, who gets what color, either red or green.
How is it for
now? And the first match is about to get underway. It's a 103 weight class. Scotch Plains, Pat Bartels, and for Cranford, we have John Cucola. Here comes Pat Bartels. And Scotch Plains is green this match. Cranford is red. And there we go. Both wrestlers grappling right now. Close to the out of bounds marker right now. And they're out of bounds. Back to the middle of the circle. 1:21 remaining in the first period. And Pat brings him down. Two points for Scotch Plains as Pat works right now on John. Pat using his weight against John right now. We had a delay from the top.
The Raiders now have 2 points. Clear for nothing.
Pat chooses to take the up position. John is down, and here we go. And Pat takes him down. John scampering for the out of bounds line. Pat doesn't let him get there. Pat brings him down. He's close to being on his back. It's 10 seconds left in the match. And that is the end of the first period. Score right now is 2-0 in favor of the Raiders. And Cranford had the choice, but John Cool deferred the choice to Pat Bartels, who chooses to go down. Pat tries to bring him down. Pat takes him down. It's 2 points for a reversal. Both wrestlers grappling right now on their knees. Pat brings him down with an armbar. John stands up. Pat throws him right back down. Pat has an armbar right now.
That's it. Come on.
1:10 remaining in the second period. The referee blew timeout.
Score now is 4-0 Raiders.
Pat Bartel's performing very well in the opening period in this match, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, of the two, he looks the taller of the two. Is it, when it comes to weight-wise, which is more important, height or weight? Does height have any advantage to it?
Height, it depends. Height and weight, it both varies with the type of wrestler you are. If you like to use moves that use your weight more than your size, then weight is definitely an advantage. However, when you have a height advantage, you can get more of the leg moves around tighter. It varies depending on the wrestler. Right now, Pat being a bit taller does have an advantage, I'd say. 44 seconds left in the second period. Score is still 4-0 in favor of Pat. Both wrestlers right now grappling. John on the bottom, Pat maintaining him on the top. John tries to stand up. Pat brings him right back down. John stands up, Pat brings him down. John right now is laying on his buttocks. Can be rolled to his back. Pat brings him over. John attempting to roll back. And that's the end of the second period. Pat didn't have a chance to get him there. Score is still 4-0 in favor of Pat Bartels, beginning of the third period coming up. Down. Pat pretty much holding him down right now. Reaching him for a wrist. Giving him back points. Pat holding him down on one shoulder blade, giving him back points. Referee called it.
Pat Bartels now has 7 points in his favor.
Just scored 3 back points. Going back to the middle, Pat on top right now. If he blows the whistle, he continues action. Last year, Pat Bartels was the state champion as a freshman. And he also had a very good record. He's basically what the Raiders need for a starting offense.
Yeah, I can see that he's the more aggressive of the two out there right now.
The Raiders do feel very lucky to have someone as powerful and as good as him to begin their lineup with. Right now trying to roll him over. Just holding him on his back. 34 seconds left in the third period. One point green for an escape. Score is now 8-0. Seven seconds left in this match. Pat holding him down. And that ends the match.
Pat Bartels won that by a score of 8-0. Quite impressive, don't you think?
Yes. The Raiders really did need a victory in the beginning to win. With that, I think the inspirations of the entire Raiders can totally just bring it back. Score is now 4-0 overall in favor of Scotch Plains. Up next at 1:12, we have for Scotch Plains, George Mendez. And for Cranford, we have Mike Carpenter. Both wrestlers grappling from the neutral position right now. Mike shoots in on George. 2 points for takedown. Mike trying to turn George around his back. Now pulled George onto his back, gave himself 2 back points. Score is now 4-0. While George takes down, Mike gets on top. Right now, both wrestlers grappling in the circle. An illegal move to the face by George. Score is now 4-1 in favor of Mike still.
Is this going the way we expected?
It's going, excuse me for 1 second. Mike pulls George down to his back. The referee is awarding him back points. And he gets the pin. George Mendez from Scotch Plains just was pinned by Mike Carpenter from Cranford. That gives Cranford the lead right now with a score of 6-4. Come on, baby. Right now, Mark Donadio at 119 is out there waiting to wrestle Willie Carpenter. It's Cranford's only state champion. Mark Donadio is a very fast and very powerful wrestler. He should give Willie a very good challenge. Out of bounds, 1:51 remaining, first period. Mark goes in. And Willie pulls Mark around, but Mark rolls over again. Willie now on top. Score is 2-0 in favor of Willie. You know, Willie Carpenter being a state champion should give Mark Donadio a really good run. Although Mark Donadio is a very good wrestler, it's going to be a definite challenge for him, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, sure is. But does he have a chance?
I think he does have a very good chance. Right now he's getting ridden.
He's only down by 2 points at this point, so.
Although he's getting ridden with a body scissors and he just received back points. Willie Carpenter getting back points on Mark Donadio and he pulls him around to his back. Mark escapes it. Mark tries to neck bridge out of it. Mark Donadio in trouble now. Mark getting rolled, went to his back and rolled totally the other way around. And Mark now on his back. No, Mark pulls it away. Mark getting pulled to his back. And we let him go, and Mark gets away. The score right now was 1 point for Scotch Plains for the escape, and the score is now 5-1 in favor of Willie Carpenter. What an interesting turn of events, wouldn't you say?
Well, I don't want to guess any judgments, but this is going to be a very tough match for Mark Donadio.
Mark Donadio giving all that he has in this match.
As soon as he throws that leg, you gotta sit, Mark.
Mark Donadio taking the down position. The referee goes over to make sure that scorekeepers know what the score is. Score is now 7-1.
With 14 seconds left in this first period.
In favor of Willie Carpenter. And Willie just let Mark go to go to the neutral position. It seems that Willie Carpenter really is good from the neutral position. Score is now 7-2. And with that, the first period ends with a score 7-2 in favor of Roy Carpenter over Mark Donadio. Willie Carpenter got the choice of where to stand, of what position to go in, and Willie chose down. And the match resumes. Second period action. 1 point for an escape into the neutral position by Cranford. It's 8-2. 1:45 remaining in the second period. Muck drops an ankle. And that's 2 points for a takedown. Score is now 10-2, and Mark Donadio appears hurt.
Mark!
Mark Donadio kneeling down in the middle, and here we go. Mark Donadio appears okay. Mark Donadio takes down. And here we go, 1:36 remaining in the second period. Score is now 10-2 in favor of Willie Carpenter.
That's it, out the back door, Elboy, the hook shot. Twisted ankle.
Mark Donadio grabbing Willie Carpenter's leg.
Keep that ankle, Elboy. Keep that ankle, Mark.
Scores now is 10-2, favoring Cranford, with 1:06 left to go in the second period.
Both wrestlers fighting for some sort of edge right now. Willie Carpenter rolling Mark Donadio around, trying to get a cradle, and he does. Mark Donadio is in the cradle. Willie's getting back points, and it looks like there's a pin. Mark Donadio has just been pinned by Willie Carpenter.
I'll give Mark Donadio credit. That was a tough matchup against the state champ.
That was. I give him a lot of credit for that match. Score is now 12-4 in favor of Cranford over the Scotch Plains Raiders.
Next up.
At 125, we have for Scotch Plains Mike Marcovecchio.
And for Cranford is Pete Scholes.
Here comes Mike Marcovecchio. Putting on his green leg band. Here we go. And there we go, 2 points. Mike Marcovecchio. Mike controlling him right now.
Scores 2-0 Raiders. Minute and a half to go in this period.
Mike pulls his head free. Drives him down. And out of bounds. 1:06 remaining in this first period. Mike Marcovecchio with a 2-0 lead over Pete Scholes. And the referee continues action. Mike Marcovecchio with an armbar, trying to pull it. Score is still 2-0 in favor of Mike Marcovecchio. Pete Scholes pretty much just laying there. Mike pulls him around, maintains control. Still on his knees. Mike grabs a leg. Mike going for the cradle and has gotten it. However, it went the wrong way.
By accident, Mike let that go, and Pete Scholes pulls him down.
Scores 2-2.
2 points there for Mike Marcovecchio. Scores now 4-2, beginning of the second period in favor of Mike Marcovecchio. What a terrible turn that was. If Mike had held the cradle and pulled him around the right way, he would have had a pin. Second period action, 2 minutes. Scores now 4-2 in favor of Mike Marcovecchio. Okay, here we go. Pete Scholes takes down, Marcovecchio comes in. And here he goes. Mike again starts by breaking him down to his body, laying on his stomach.
Watch yourself. Watch it.
Mike with a leg tucked inside, could get rolled, but no. He pulls it around. He has a body scissors on. Pete Scholes right now. Pete in considerable trouble right now. As you hear the moans and groans and screams of the crowd here at SPFHS.
Basically the parents of these students.
Amazingly enough, the parents here are being louder than the students are. This is another great conference matchup, another good rivalry. We should expect it to get really loud pretty soon. 106 remaining in this second period, scores 4-2 in favor of Marcovecchio. Mike tries to bring him over and thoroughly misses with that move. Mike trying to roll over so he can get back control. Has his leg wrapped around the leg. And the escape and the reversal. That's 2 points for Pete Scholes with the reversal right there. It scores 4-4. It's tied. 40 seconds left in the second period. Marcovecchio now takes down. Marcovecchio rolls back to his base. Sits through. And Marcovecchio right now.
20 seconds left in this period.
Marcovecchio in considerable trouble right now.
Andy, from what you've seen of these wrestlers so far, who do you think is going to prevail?
Right now on the mat, Marcovecchio is in serious trouble getting pinned. Pete Scholes right now is pulling him down as you hear the Cranford crowd going nuts. But that is the end of the second period. 3 more points have been awarded to Pete.
Scores 9-4 Cranford.
Pete Scholes with a very surprising and very good effort right there at the end of the period. He's done that twice so far, the end of the first and the end of the second period. He's had incredible moves. If he can just do those in the middle of the period, I think he might have a chance. Pete Scholes down. Mike Marcovecchio comes in. Gets on, here we go. Pete trying to stand up. Mike holds him and remains in control. Score is 9-4 in favor of Pete. Scholes with both knees out of bounds. Marcovecchio edging him back in. No. We have the neutral position right now. Score is 10-4. 1 point awarded to Cranford.
You think Marcovecchio is going to be able to catch up at this point?
I think he should go for a pin instead of trying to catch up. Out of bounds.
back into the middle, neutral position. With 1:30 left in the second, in the third period, Marco Vecchio must get a pin right now in order to win. I'm not sure if he can actually score up to 7 points to tie or to win by points.
Especially with 1:20 left in the final period.
Yes. Back to the neutral position. Pete right now holding Marco Vecchio. Very close to the out-of-bounds line, and they just crossed it. 1:04 remaining in the third period. Back to the middle. Neutral possession. Play resuming. Pete pushing Mike's head down. To no avail. Both close to the out-of-bounds line, and they just crossed it again. Marco Vecchio coming back to the center circle. Neutral position. 45 seconds remaining. Pete shoots in. Mike sprawls and recovers.
Score is still 10-4 with just about half a minute left to go in the period.
If Pete Scholes gets two more points, he'll win by 8 points, and that's a superior decision. That's 4 points for the overall team. We have an injury timeout right now. There we see the referee with Coach Zanowitz, our athletic trainer, Jim Schlimovitz, and they're both attending to Mike Marco Vecchio. Timeout is over. Action will resume. Neutral position, here we go. 30 seconds left. Score is 10-5.
Seconds left to go in the period.
Score is 10-5 with 2 points.
Score is
makes 12-5. And that's the end of the match. Final score of that match, 12-5 in favor of West, in favor of Cranford.
Score now is 15-4 Cranford. Hey, this is kind of a runaway, isn't it? This so early?
Well, not exactly. Right now, at 1:30, we got Andy Spot Brown coming up for Scotch Plains against Eric Nowicki. This will be a very good match. Spot Brown is a very consistent and powerful wrestler. Spot Brown, definitely, Scotch Plains would definitely appreciate it if Spot got a pin right now. No points awarded just yet. Both grappling in the neutral position. Andy Brown brings him down. 2 points, Scotch Plains.
Scores 2-0 Raiders.
Back to the center. And Eric is taken down. Brown takes top. And wait, Andy Brown appears to have called for an injury timeout. Coach Glimovitz comes over to help him.
I'm sorry, can you get that for me?
Play resumes. 1:22 left. And Andy Brown takes him over. Andy Brown being awarded back points. Eric in trouble now, and he gets him on his back. But he rolls back over. Slap Brown in trouble now. Andy had a reversal. Andy being brought down. Andy on his back. Score is 5-2 in favor of Spot Brown. Andy standing up. And out of bounds. Very interesting turn of events, wouldn't you say, Anthony?
Yeah, I sure would. We're progressing in weights, it does get a little more exciting.
Andy Brown, a definite favorite here at Scotch Plains. Spot Brown bringing him around, both grappling toward the end of the circle. 18 seconds left in the first period. Back to center in neutral position.
Just 7 seconds left to go in this first period.
Score is 6-2 in favor of Spot Brown. Out of bounds, and that's the end of the period. Okay, Cranford gets a choice. Cranford deferred the choice to Scotch Plains. Andy Brown chose top, the offensive position. Second period action underway, 6-2 in favor of Andy Brown. Both wrestlers grappling in the middle. Andy Brown had him down for a second on his back.
Score still remains 6-2. Minute 30 in the second period.
Eric pulls back, gets a reversal, and a spot on his back. Eric right now getting back points. Spot Brown in trouble. Spot turns back over. It's 3 points award to Cranford. Scores now 7-6. In favor, the score, the leader has changed. Right now, Cranford in charge. Bring him down. It's 2 back points. Score is now 9-6. Eric really coming on here in the second period. Eric definitely in command here. 32 seconds left in the second period. The crowd definitely getting into it here. You know, Anthony, you have to figure that the crowd must be a major advantage to the home team wrestling in this.
Yeah, sure is. To our left here is the Cranford side.
That's what you can hear right now.
And a lot of people turned out for this match.
Out of bounds, 5 seconds left. Cranford definitely the much louder school represented here tonight. Andy Brown took the down position for the whole 5 seconds he's going to be there. If he wants to score any points, he has to move quick right now. And there he goes, he got a point. 1 point for the escape. Score is now 9-7 in favor of Eric Nowicki. You know, as tough of a wrestler as Spot Brown is, this Eric Nowicki, he's making a lot of moves that are really even confusing Andy, I think.
Yeah, I agree with you right there.
Right now,
Andy's a very strong wrestler for this team. How many years have you been on here?
This will be his fourth year.
Fourth year.
Jim Shumovitz, our athletic trainer at the high school, attending to spot right now.
See the coach talking to Nowicki there. Back to Scotch Plains side.
There we go. Timeout is over. Cranford gets the choice. And they choose to be down. Spot Brown coming around. Spot Brown just got rolled. Eric taking the advantage right now. Putting his head inside. 2 points for a reversal. Cranford. Scores now 11-7. That right there was just the hold by Andy Brown. Holding Eric right now on his back. 2 points awarded for the reversal. Score is 11-9. Andy Brown trying to bring him to his back. Eric standing up. Spot Brown reaching inside.
Score is still 11-9. 43 seconds left to go in the final period.
Andy trying to pull him over to his side, to his back. We have a warning right there on Cranford. And he gets him in a cradle. Spot Brown has Eric in a cradle. However, he can't bring him around, and he just lost it.
20 seconds left.
Up to the neutral position, 1 point for the escape. Eric, out of bounds. Neutral position right now, score is 12-9 in favor of Eric. Scott Brown needs 3 points. That's the end of the match. With 2 points awarded to Scotch Plains, it's not enough. Score, final score of this match, 12-11. What an incredible match. That gives 3 points to Cranford. The score is now 18-4 in favor of Cranford.
Next up at 135 will be Pete San Giuliano.
And for Cranford, Jason Alvatore. Pete San Giuliano, a cousin of the 140 wrestler for Scotch Plains, Ralph San Giuliano. Pete shoots in. Right there, it's 2 points for Cranford. Takedown has been awarded to Jason. Jason in control right now. Right now, Jason sitting on top. Pete standing up, trying to spin around and out of it, doesn't work. Pete bringing him in.
We had an illegal move right there. It's 1 point Scotch points for that. He pulled his leg up and around and tried to lock the foot on the inside. It's an illegal move. 1 point award to Scotch Plains.
With just a little over a minute left in the first period, the score is 2-1, Cranford.
Peter taking the down position, having Jason on top. Jason brings Pete down. Pete tries to get away. He's got him in a single leg. He loses it and shoots him. Pete right now sitting on top of him. Timeout right there, so Pete Sangiuliano can put his headgear back on. Score is still 2-1 in favor of Jason. Peter takes down. And we had a caution on red because it came on the wrong side. Boy, Jason's really eager to get a Pete, huh? With two cautions right there. Jason brings him around, tries to ankle trip him. Pete trying to run away from that move, taken down by the leg. The bellowing voice you might hear at home is the Cranford coach yelling instructions. However, the period ended and he lost his offensive move. Score is 2-1 in favor of Jason Alvatore's Cranford. Pete had the choice, but he deferred it to Cranford. Jason chooses, and he takes down. Pete Sangiuliano awaits the call of the referee to come in. He brings him in, and we're underway. Trying to grab the head to bring him around to his back for the pin. Attempting again, however, ooh. Very interesting move by Pete Sangiuliano. Brings him down to his back. Reverses a half. Being awarded back points. He could receive the pin at this moment. Jason trying everything to pull out. First and a half. Jason's holding him down on his back. Referee in position to call for the pin. 6 seconds left in the second period. And Jason gets out. 3 back points awarded to Pete Sangiuliano. Jason appeared to be going on offense for a moment, but Pete swiftly took it back. Scores 4-2 in favor of Pete Sangiuliano. Both wrestlers dangerously near the out-of-bounds marker right now. And out-of-bounds. Back to the inside of the circle. Jason takes down, very winded as you can see. And Pete gets on top.
Andy, am I correct in assuming the Scotch Plains really needs a win here, considering they're
down by 14 points?
Yeah.
Scotch Plains definitely needs a pin right now.
or at least they can use one really, really a lot. Pisan Joyal pulls him down, close to the out of bounds. However, that's the end of the period. No points awarded for that. Scotch Points gets a choice. Scores 4-2 in favor of Pete Sangiuliano. Injury timeout. There's an injury timeout right now. Both wrestlers appear to be very tired. There you see the Cranford coaches dealing with Jason Alvator and Jim Shumovitz.
So we're going to start the third period. The score is 4-2 Raiders.
Match about to start again. Third period action. Score is still 4-2 in favor of Pete. However, we have the reversal right there by Pete. 6-2. Pete Sangiuliano takes him down. Pete Sangiuliano trying to bring him to his back. However, Jason is not letting him. Jason brought down, however, out of bounds. Back to center we go. 1:19 remaining in the third period. The score is 6-2 in favor of Pete. You know, Anthony, Sangiuliano is really dominating this match. He hasn't let Jason really pull any offensive moves of his own.
Well, again, I've said it, but both, you know, strong teams obviously got the same records. I'm just a little amazed by the lead so far, but hopefully we can turn that around.
I think we can. As of now, Pete Sangiuliano has had Jason on his back for most of the match. Jason pulls away from that. They're up in the neutral position. The score is 6-3.
45 seconds left in the period.
And the match. 2 points for a reversal. Score is 6-5. In favor of Pete. 1 point Scotch Plains for the escape. 7-5.
Another 2 points makes the score 9-5. Raiders.
Pete needs to hold on for 20 seconds to win this match. Score is 9-5. Pete brings him down. Eight seconds remaining. And this match appears to be over. And so it is. Very, very good match wrestled by Pete Sangiuliano. Final score of this match, 5-9-5.
Well, good job. I'm sure he would have won that pin, though.
It could have helped, but the three will help them anyway. They're only down by 11 now. The score is 18-7 in favor of Cranford. Up next at 140, Pete's cousin Ralph Sangiuliano will be going against Cranford's Luke Lukash. Here comes Ralph. Strapping on his ankle band. Right now, Scotch Plains would definitely need a pin. If they did score a pin right now, it would help. And it would give the upper weights more of an advantage not to have to have all the pressure on them to win.
And here we go. Ralph, a very strong and consistent wrestler for Scotch Plains. How do you think that this match is going to go, Anthony?
Well, of course, we hope it goes well. I've got a concern that they have an 11-point lead. So far, it's been kind of runaway, but you know, once we get in these higher weights, maybe we might just have more of a chance.
As we were speaking just now, 2 points awarded to both participants of this match for a takedown, for a reversal. Back to the center. Luke Lukash getting down, and Ralph getting on top. Right now, Ralph holding onto a leg. Ralph uses his weight and brings him down. Score is still 2-2 with 41 seconds left in the period. Ralph Sangiuliano bringing him up on the top. Luke noticing how they're out of bounds. Luke standing up, grabbing a leg, driving Ralph down, they're out of bounds. Which is lucky for Ralph, because if they weren't, Ralph could have been in trouble right there.
If you didn't see our first wrestling match that we've done this year, Andy is a former wrestler out because of injury this year. And you were heavyweight?
I was heavyweight, yes. The wrestling program here at Scotch Plains Fairmont High School is a very promising program with a lot of younger wrestlers in it.
They seem to be continuing what they were doing last year. They were very strong last year. They just seem to continue right down through.
Yes, what they're doing is Coach Zanowicz is trying as hard as he can to get the younger people involved in wrestling more than the older ones, because the older ones are going to graduate. The younger ones, like the freshmen, can give them 4 solid years of wrestling.
Yeah, well, I was speaking to the athletic director. You know, he said that the middle school wrestlers aren't going through, and they're going to investigate that. In order to keep our wrestling program strong, they're going to have to. I mean, people just usually don't take up with the sport in high school.
They usually follow it throughout their entire scholastic career. However, wrestling, compared to football or baseball or soccer, wrestling is a dying art. I mean, most everyone as kids plays Pee Wee League soccer or, you know, Little League or something, but wrestling is a sport that not many people usually follow or play. And that's one thing Coach Zanowicz is trying to change right now. End of the first period, 2 minutes left. In the second period, the score is still tied, 2-2.
Isn't our JV team doing also well tonight? This season?
Our JV team is doing very well. The guidance of the varsity team has been helping them greatly. There are a lot of juniors and sophomores on the team, as well as a multitude of freshmen.
Which looks promising for years to come.
Yes, it does. This year, we've probably had the biggest amount of freshmen we've had for a few years.
The question is, I can ask you, once our seniors leave this year, what do you think is going to be the status of this team? Do you think they're going to still be able to compete in this conference?
They're still going to be able to compete with juniors such as Mark Gottlick, Scott Rosander, with juniors like Kevin Burke. You're going to have a lot of very powerful and talented wrestlers who are going to be able to train and help the younger people.
Do you have any idea if they're going to be training throughout the summer with the weight program here?
They do work out in the weight room. Some of them are on the football team. Our football team this year was group
state champs, right?
Group state champions, yes. I like to say that. There are different wrestling camps available for wrestlers to go to if they wish. There are a lot of opportunities for wrestlers. However, it's not such a popular or popularized sport as football or baseball. That's the only problem with the program. Right now, 39 seconds left in the second period. Ralph Sangiuliano with an edge of 1 point. Score is 3-2.
Score is only 3-2, Raiders so far. With 19 seconds left in the second period. Good out bounds.
Both wrestlers come back into the center of the circle. 17 seconds remaining. With 5 seconds left, someone should shoot. However, we had 1 point for each. Score is now 4-3, 3 seconds left. Ralph shoots in. No points awarded. Score is now 4-3 in favor of Ralph San Giuliano. Third period. Lukash gets his choice and he takes down. However, his hand is bleeding. So we have an injury timeout right now.
Swiped it up off real quick and back out.
Ralph getting on top, and here we go. Luke trying to stand up and pull around. Ralph holding onto the leg. .141 remaining in the third period. Both wrestlers grasping, trying to get control. Right now, it appears that Luke has just received control. And he pulls around this side. 2 points awarded right there. Score is 5-4 in favor of Luke Cash.
Again, Scotch Plains is still looking for that pin.
They definitely are.
They really use one.
Down by 11 points. With only 6 matches left after this, they could use it.
A lot is resting on the heavier of the wrestlers. We only have 6 matchups after this, so everyone counts.
Definitely. Both wrestlers rolling around in the center, trying to get control. And it appears that Lukash lets Ralph go. Neutral position, the score is 5-5, 45 seconds left. Ralph rolls onto his butt. And Ralph brings him back around. Ralph can get him down. 29 seconds left, Ralph's getting back points. If Ralph can hold him, he's winning 7-5. Score is now 9-5, 2 back points. A 4-point lead right now for Ralph San Giuliano. 9 seconds left in this match. With a delay right there, an illegal move, 1 point red. It's Cranford. Score is now 9-6. Here we go. All Ralph has to do is just hold on. And he did, and Ralph gets the win. By a score of 9-6, the Scotch Plains Raiders just received 3 more points. The score is now 18-10. Very interesting matchup. Coming up next at 1:45, we have Mike Kane, senior for Scotch Plains, against Nick Lettery from Cranford. Anthony, how do you think this match is going to come out?
Well, now we're getting up into the heavier weights. They seem to be a little more exciting. Mike Kane's a great wrestler, so we'll see what happens. You've had more experience with these guys than I have. What's your opinion?
My opinion right now, as Mike Kane gets taken over.
Well, obviously a great start.
Extremely.
Mike Kane. Good matchup.
It definitely should. Nick Lettery is a very good wrestler. Mike Kane.
Cranford takes a quick lead of 2-0.
Lettery brings him down. It's 2 points for a reversal. Scores 2-2. It's tied. Mike Kane holding him down. Scores now 3-2 in favor of Lettery. Mike Kane being brought down. However, Mike Kane takes the offensive. If he can pull his head free, and he just did. 2 points right there for the reversal. Scores 4-3. This is definitely a toss-up. The tide, so to speak, has
changed. Both wrestlers came up very strong, so there should be a lot of points amounted here.
42 seconds left in the first period. And there's something to happen. Mike Kane goes down. And Lettery gets the reversal. 2 points.
Score now is 5-4 Cranford.
Out of bounds, back to the center. Go. 19 seconds left in the first period. Nick in control right now. Mike Kane tries to spin out. And that's the end of the first period. The score being 5-4 in favor of Lettery. Nick takes the down position, and Mike Kane is about to come in to take on his offensive position. Kane on top.
Score still is 5-4 Cranford with about a minute 30 left to go in the second period.
Kane holds him up. We had an illegal move right there. As Nick Lettery gets into the middle. And here comes Kane. Nick brought down. Mike desperately trying to roll him over. Right now, Nick going for the reversal, and he's got it.
Just under a minute left.
Six seconds left. Action resumes. 41 seconds remaining in the second period. Score is still 5-4 in favor of Lettery. Out of bounds, they roll. 25 seconds left in the second period, they come back into the center.
Nick takes down, and Mike gets on top. Neutral position, 1 point red for the escape. Score is 6-4. Mike grapples up with him. Mike brought down to his back. 2 points for the takedown.
1 second, that's second period. Score is 8-4, Cranford.
It's 10-4 with the 2 points for that takedown. Mike Kane takes choice right now. He takes down. Cranford will get the choice. Okay. It's very loud out here. It's pretty hard to hear anything said by anyone, really. 1:50 remaining. Score being 10-4 in favor of Nick. .130 remaining. Nick in control of Mike, trying to bring him down to his back. Mike spinning around, totally trying to avoid that. Seconds remaining, score is still 10-4. Mike Kane right now is down on his knees. Nick pulling his arm if
score
he can.
Score remains at 10-4, just 40 seconds left to go.
Score being 11-4 with that 1 point just scored. The Cranford crowd getting into it.
Just 15 seconds left. Mike can do something now really quick.
Mike Kane in trouble right now. And that's the end of the match. The score being 12-4. He won by a spare decision. That's 4 points. Score being 10 points for the Raiders and 22 for Cranford. Up next at 1:52 for Scotch Plains, we have Scott Rosander, a junior three-year letterman. And for Cranford, we have Brian Lettery. Scott Rosander with 2 points for the apparent takedown. Or at least for getting control. Scott Rosander almost had him on his back. He's getting back points. And he blew the whistle for an illegal move. It's 2 back points for Scottish Plains. Score is now 4-2 in favor of Scott Rosander over Brian Lettery. You know, throughout 3 years now, Scott Rosander has been a very consistent wrestler for Scotch Plains.
I'm sure he's going to come back next year. He's going to be very strong, you know, and he's junior now, senior next year. He's really going to get some good matchups next year. That's something that's going to keep this team alive for just another year, and I'm sure it'll build up.
the experience and knowledge of the seniors of this year, seniors being, of course, Andy Brown, Mike Kane, Mark Dambau, and Al Scarpa. With their knowledge and wisdom about wrestling and about leadership, they can teach the juniors and the underclassmen, which they do in practice, how to lead and what it takes to make a wrestling team. And what that does is, then when they become the seniors and the seniors graduate, the seniors take over where the old seniors were. That's the job, basically, of a senior or a captain on the wrestling team.
Score is 4-0 so far. Scott Rosander of Scottish Plains Fanwood. 30 seconds left to go in the first period.
Overall score, again, being 22-10 in favor of Cranford. Seconds left. Nothing else is going to happen. Right now, beginning of the second period, the score is 4-1 in favor of Scotch Plains. Scotch Plains takes his choice, and Scott Rosander is taking the defensive position. Play continues. Now, score being 4-1 with 1:42 remaining in the second period. Scott Rosander on the bottom at this point. And here we are, we're in the neutral position. The score is 5-1, Scott Rosander. Close to the out of bounds as Brian rolls off the mat and onto the extremely tough Scotch Plains Parquet. Well, it's not right Parquet, but that's what everybody here calls it, so. Right now, Scott Rosander, seemingly in trouble. However, Scott can defend himself with this, as he's doing. And that's new eagle hold. Both wrestlers grappling up, 56 seconds remaining in the second period. Scott Rosander shoots in, pulls his head free. That's 2 points right there for Scott Rosander. The score is 7-1. Scott brings him down to his back. He's getting back points. That's three back points for Scott Rosander.
Scott's doing really well in this matchup. These points are really gonna be useful to the team.
They definitely shall. Scott Rosander scoring now a total of 10 points.
I thought before, I thought that, you know, the heavyweight matches would be a little bit stronger.
It appears that the heavier you go up, the more competitive the matches are gonna be. Right around the middle, right? Between, actually, up to about 189, 171, there are a lot of moves being used.
That's the second period. Scott Rosander leads by a score of 10-2.
You know, Scott, is, as well as being an outstanding wrestler for the team, is also a very academic scholar. He's a very good student here at Scotch Plains Fanwood High School. And will definitely enjoy the rest of this year as well as next year as a wrestler and a student. Play about to resume, or about to start in the third period. Score is 10-2. No, we have caution on Scott Rosander. There we go. Scott apparently didn't wait for the referee to signal him to come in. He just kind of came in on his own. But unfortunately, he can't do that. Scott wrestling, trying to get control, which he has. Scott grabbing for an ankle.
See, the experience shows when you go up in these weight classes. You know, Scott's a junior. You can see he's really experienced in wrestling.
He appears to be more experienced than Brian Lattery with the moves and the way he's using his moves. Out of bounds. Score right now is 10-2. Right now, Scott Rosander. Scott Rosander trying to get some points, just to seal his win. 55 seconds left in the third period. He leads by a score of 10-2. Scott brings him down, rolls him on his back, to no avail. 30 seconds left. Scott can hold him. He will have beaten him by 8 points. That's 4 more points to Scotch Plains, another superior decision.
Again, Scott's doing a great job in this matchup. Score is 10-2, just 20 seconds left to go.
Yes, overall right now, with the way Scott Rosander is wrestling, he should have no trouble winning this match. When things like that happen and the opposing wrestler gets 2 points for a reversal, Scott just lost. Any chance, unless he can get 2 points, I'm getting a superior decision. 6 seconds left. And Scotty won that match.
Great win.
The score now, overall, is Cranford has 22 points and the Raiders 13.
Next up at the 160 level is Dave Osislo against Wayne Bender of Cranford.
Osislo, or Oz as he is called, was the punter for the varsity football team, the state champion varsity football team this year. And here comes Wayne. Both wrestlers grappling right now, no points awarded. Okay. No points awarded just yet, out of bounds. Back to the neutral position. No points awarded just yet, 105 remaining. Out of bounds. Back to the middle. Okay, 42 seconds remaining in the first period. Dave Russell has a 2-0 lead. Wayne Bender not doing much in this match, basically. Steve also still pulling him out of bounds, grabbing an arm. And they're both out of bounds. Back to the middle. 9 seconds left in the first period. Oscar still takes the offensive position. Four seconds left, they just went out of bounds. Score is now 2-0 at the end of the first period.
That's the period. With only about three more matchups left in this meet, Dave Osisla really needs to win everything he can here.
Scotch Plains team would definitely appreciate it if you got a pin for 6 points, or at least a spirit decision for 4. Scampering toward the out-of-bounds marker is Wayne Bender.
Really crawling out of there. He's really crawling out of there.
Oh, definitely. And he just went out of bounds. A lot of the times when wrestlers appear to be in trouble or feel that they're in trouble, they scamper out of bounds to try to decide something. Also for Scotch Plains, if you're keeping score at home, at 189, Kevin Burke is wrestling for Scotch Plains. They've decided that. I'm sorry, my mistake. Mark Gottlick is wrestling for Scotch Plains, if you decide that. Mark Gottlick, not Kevin Burke. Last made a decision by the Scotch Plains coaches.
Not many points awarded so far. It's only 2-0. Second period, 1:16 left to go.
Oz has to hold him down.
There you go. Go ahead, Dave. Under a minute.
Score is now 2-0. Oz still had him on his back for a minute. He pulled away. Two seconds remaining in the second period of action. The score is, surprisingly enough, is very low. Only 2-0. Dealing with the 2 points being awarded for a takedown by Dave Osso in the first period.
Well, I guess that 2-0 score shows that, it's a close matchup here.
Definitely. Twenty-one seconds remaining. Osso gets on top of Wayne, and here we go. Osso going for the juice, and he pulls it off. Oz brings him down. Oz pulls away from that. Rolling around on his head. Very impressive move by Dave Osso.
3, 2, 1.
And the score is still 2-0. We're just about to start the third period. Overall, the team has a score of 22-13.
Scotch Plains is only down by 9 with a match of 171, 89, and heavyweight remaining. Scotch Plains can pull this one off. I get the feeling it's going to be close at the end, though. It scores now 2-1 for that escape. In the neutral position right now. Wayne appearing to be in control, which he is.
Westfield then scored a point. Score now is 2-1. Minute 15 left to go in the match. Stand still.
Right now, both coaches standing at the edge of the mat, hollering instructions to the wrestlers, trying to make something happen, and they're out of bounds. Up to the neutral position, 55 seconds remaining. The score is 2-1 in favor of Dave Vasilisla. Russell shoots him. He has a hold of a leg. Windbender cross faces. Dave pulls him in, shoots. However, Wayne falls right on top of him. Dave does have an ankle, however, so he hasn't gotten the 2 points awarded for the takedown yet.
Just 20 seconds left to go.
And he just got it.
Scores 3-2. Cranford. 15 seconds left.
Dave Vasilisla needs 1 point to tie it, 2 points to win it. The crowd is on their feet here at Scotch Plains Fairmont High School. The crowd is loud, they're up. They're wanting to win.
Seconds, six.
Vasilisla has 5 seconds to get a point. And the 2 points for Scotch Plains. Vasilisla pulls it out.
Third three.
Vasilisla pulls the match out with 1 second remaining on the clock. Gets the 2 points for the reversal. What an incredible matchup. Vasilisla wins by a score of 4-3. The overall score now is 22-16 in favor of Cranford.
That's a good win right there.
That was definitely an incredible match, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, right at the end there. Really heated up. Really exciting, kind of like the Super Bowl 25.
New York Giants edging out the Buffalo Bills by a score of 20-19. Definitely a good game. However, my team being the Miami Dolphins, I couldn't really root for either of them. But they lost to the Bills, so I was not really that upset.
And now back to wrestling here at Scotch Plains Fairmont High School.
At 171, we have from the Scotch Plains, Mark Dambo.
Against Brian Nordstrom of Cranford.
Mark Dambo, a very powerful and consistent wrestler.
4-year member.
I think that he will prevail in this match.
No points awarded yet so far. 130 into the first. 130 left in the first period.
Dimba shoots in for a leg, and they're out of bounds. Dimba brings them around. They're tied up. 113 remaining. There's no score. At the halfway point in the first period, there's no score.
And do you think that's odd this far into this match?
No, when you have a wrestler, you have wrestlers the caliber of this. Obviously, Windbender is a very intuitive wrestler. using his moves against Mark Danbaum. I'm sorry, not Windbender, Brian Nordstrom. Danbaum tied up with him. Releases him, they're out of bounds.
Again, we're at the 171 level here.
Mark Danbaum releases whatever he had.
Just under 20 seconds left to go in the first period. No points awarded so far.
Grappling up, neutral position.
Five seconds remaining. And that's
vicious
period.
Move out of bounds. That being the end of the first period, the score is tied.
And do you think we're going to see more excitement in this matchup? I mean, the first period was kind of quiet with no points.
Both wrestlers were basically just feeling each other out, trying to determine who was the stronger of the two. Right now, they know each other. I think Mark Danbaum or Brian Nordstrom can do something. We have 1 point for Cranford right there. Nordstrom with the escape. Doe. Right now, the overall score in the match being 22-16, Scotch Plains being down by 6. If Mark Danbaum pinned Brian Nordstrom, it would tie the whole thing up. Ooh, Mark Danbaum drives him out of bounds.
Minute left to go in the second period. Score is only 1-0. So an opportunity for anyone to win here.
Mark Danbaum now trying to fix his headgear. Here we go. Score is 1-0 in favor of Brian Nordstrom. Danbaum shoots in, out of bounds. Almost hitting those cheerleaders over there. Back in action, Mark Danbaum shoots inside. Out of bounds.
21 seconds left to go in the second period. Just 1 point earned by Cranford. So the match is still close.
That's very surprising to me. Mark Danbaum has shot in numerous times and has attempted for many, many point conversions. However, he's attempted them and tried them, but has not accomplished any of them. This is very strange.
Just 2 seconds remaining. The score will end up, after the second period, 1-0.
And that being the end of the second period, Mark Danbaum chooses down, scores 1-0. Here we go. Nordstrom, a lefty. As noted, by the way, he came into his offensive position. Dembele grabbing the head, trying to roll him. Not accomplished. Out of bounds. 1:42 remaining in the third period. Dembele definitely needed some form of points. Nordstrom rolling him around. Back to the center we go. Mark Dembele is down, Brian Nordstrom is still on top. Dembele, someone in trouble right now. Brian Nordstrom, surprisingly, a very quick wrestler. Using more power moves, but using them quickly, which is very surprising. Out of bounds. 1:04 remaining in the third period. The score being 1-0 in favor of Brian Nordstrom. Action resumes. Dembele definitely trying to get a...
he knows he needs points right here.
Just trying to get out of it at that point.
If he doesn't win, it's going to be a lot of pressure on those heavyweights.
Dembele does definitely not want that. He's trying to get some points, possibly get a win here. Dembele trying to pull himself out of bounds, which he did, to get back in the center. 45 seconds remaining in this match. Dembele needs a point or two. 1 point, he'll tie it. 2 points, which is, I'm sure, what he wants, and he'll win it. Because tying this match won't do much except giving both teams points. And right now, the Raiders need more points than just tying it up. Out of bounds. Mark Dembele was just called for unsportsmanlike conduct, or the equivalent of that. 1 point was awarded to Cranford. Dembele, obviously. 38 seconds remaining. Scott, Mark Dembele is down 2-0 to Brian Nordstrom. Out of bounds. 31 seconds remaining. Mark Dembele needs 3 points. Mark has to escape from this. He has to get a reversal. Out of bounds. 26 seconds remaining. This match is turning out to be just like the other one. It's going to be decided right at the end.
Adrenaline's high here. You can see how these wrestlers are moving around. They're moving around real fast now.
They have to win. Mark Dembele realizes that he has to win for Scotch Plains to win.
20 seconds.
Brian Nordstrom just riding Mark Dembele, not allowing him to do anything. Seconds remaining. Out of bounds with 1 second remaining. If Mark Dembele can somehow manage to score 3 points in 1 second, I don't know how he's going to do it, but
it'd be some miracle, I tell you.
Like the clock breaks or. And there we go.
That being the end of the match, Cranford's won this one by a score of 2-0. The overall score right now is 25-16. Scotch Plains needs both victories. He needs at least one pin and a decision. They cannot win with two decisions. They must get a pin.
Well, Mark Gottlieb and Al Scarpa have a lot riding on their shoulders right now.
Mark Gottlieb wrestling 189 right now.
Gottlieb against
George and Esser. And here he comes. You know, you can tell the pressure is on Gottlieb right now.
Well, as you remember, the Westfield match, that last matchup had the whole meat riding on it. Well, I'm sure he's glad he doesn't have that pressure on him this time around.
He doesn't have that much pressure, but he still has a lot. If he wins, gives Al Scarpa more time to relax, not have to worry that the whole match is on his shoulders. Gottlieb, a very strong and powerful wrestler, uses strength and his power as well as all the moves he knows.
Well, as long as, you know, you have to have a brain, you have to have the smarts, and I think he has that, too.
He definitely does. He's a very academic scholar, as well as an athlete playing football and wrestling. Halfway through the first period, the score is 4-1 in favor of Anessa. Right now, we see that Mark Gottlieb is down with 30 seconds remaining in the first period by a score of 4-1. Mark Gottlieb getting rolled over onto his back. George and Esser getting back points.
13 seconds left.
And George unfortunately received the pin there. Terrible, terrible from Scotch Plains. The pin coming in the second in that period. That makes the score 31-16. And as unfortunate as it seems, Scotch Plains needs 15 points in one match to win. And for some reason, I don't think they're gonna get it. Seeing that the most you can get is 6.
Yeah.
Well, at heavyweight, we have Al Scarpa going against Rich Pinno, a man I definitely know very well.
And why is that?
Well, Rich Pinno was the first person that I ever wrestled as a wrestler for Scotch Plains.
Perhaps you'd like to go out there?
I don't want to go out there right now. My elbow still hurts. Anyway, Al Scarpa's going to have his hands full because Rich is a very good wrestler. He did beat me, by the way, in case you were wondering. But that's past history, that's nothing going on. 10 seconds have lapsed, no score. But just rolled over Rich Pinto with 2 points for the takedown. If he can hold him onto his back, he's got the pin. Rich Pinto scrambling for the out of bounds marker.
Scarpa is really holding him in though.
Three back points for Al Scarpa. He's leading now 5-0. Rich Pinto takes down. Al Scarpa is getting on top. And here he comes. Al drives him down to the mat. brings him down with a half. He reverses it. He's getting back points. It's two. He's got him down now. And there he goes, the pin for Al Scarpa. Six more points awarded to Scotch Plains. However,
that'll make the score 31-22. That's the end of this here meet.
It doesn't do it for him.
Well, we thank you for joining us here on 34 Sports. Other sport, Raider Sports will be on this channel, as well as 34 News. Hope you'll stay tuned to this station throughout the weeks to come. I'm Anthony Albanese.
I'm Andy Schwartz.
And thank you for joining us. Bye-bye for now.
Have a nice night.